Hi students, in this video we'll see the cryoscopic method, isotonicity adjustment methods. In the previous video I have already explained you what is how to adjust the isotonicity, what are the methods are available. This is a part 2 video. See the part 1 video also. Okay, first see the one and you can be later we get part 2. This method is called as a cryoscopic method. Cryo means cooling, cryo means refrigerator, cryo means freezer. Okay, here in this principle we are adjusting the isotonicity of the given formulation of IV infusion. We are adjusting its isotonicity along with the blood by using the principle of its freezing point. Freezing point, what is the freezing point? We will check it and according to that we will add the NaCl. Okay, right. So this slide I have already shown you in my previous video. First point, cryoscopic. See, the totally there is a 4 methods are the class 1 method, class 2 methods. Here you can see cryoscopic, here NaCl equivalent method, here this is a white Vincent method, this is a Sprowls method. I have already explained. Class 1 methods by the addition of a salts, class 2 methods addition of the water. Okay, that I have already explained, that's why you watch it. Now cryoscopic method, this I am going to be explained. First point in the exam, what you have to write in the exam, they will give direct question, cryoscopic method you explain. First point you write, cryoscopic method is used to adjust the isotonicity of the given formulation. Point number 1. Number 2, it comes in the class 1 methods. Okay, next, third point, in this method we are adding the salt, so we are adjusting the isotonicity. Third point completed. Fourth point, cryoscopic method is also called as a L-ISO method. 4 points completed. See how to write in a systematic way, you have to be right. Yeah, main basic concept of this is a freezing point. It is a fridge, that's why this is called a cryoscopic. What you have to do in order to make this solution isotonic with the blood, we are matching the freezing point. So freezing point of the your formulation, this infusion, it must be equal to the freezing point of the blood. That is a target, okay, in this method. Okay, so what is the freezing point of the blood? -0.52. you know freezing point means where the liquid blood converted into solid blood, freeze, it will become freeze. We will play, no, freeze means freeze, like that. It becomes a freeze. Liquid which is flowing freely, dancing freely, it will become a fridge. That's why this is called a freezing method, freezing. So at -0.52 degree centigrade, that you have to keep in your mind, fix, fix, fix. Okay, so minus, not the place, okay, minus zero. What is the freezing point of the water? 0 degrees. We know very well, ice you will get. Okay, and see, if anybody will give this formulation, you adjust the isotonicity, then what you have to do, you check the freezing point. Definitely it will be more than -0.52. then what you have to do, you add the salt and again check it, so it doesn't come to -0.52. again you add the salt, again check it, again you add the salt, again check it. So you have to addition of the salt and you have to check what is the freezing point up to. So freezing point of the formulation must be -0.52 degree centigrade. That is a, you have to fix in your mind. That's it. What we have to, in olden days, that they are adding the salt, they are checking. Adding the salt, they are checking. Adding the NaCl, checking. Nowadays, it was changed. Calculation, simple calculations will come here. So how to add the salt? See here, freezing point of the water is equal to 0.0. degree centigrade. Freezing point of the 0.9 NaCl is -0.52. that's why we are using always, anywhere you see 0.9% of NaCl will be there wherever you go. When it is using alone, not the NaCl and dextrose, not a combination, you see the alone NaCl alone 0.9%, that's it. When you are combining, percentage vary definitely. See, freezing point of dextrose alone, 5%, -0.52, exactly. That's why 5%, wherever you see dextrose 5%, these also you have to fix in your mind. They will not give in the examination sometimes. So freezing point of the blood, minus 0.52. Like that, you have to match it exactly. Okay. See, here, freezing point of the water is 0.00 degrees centigrade. How to make it 0.52 means just add the salt. Add the salt. So freezing point will be depressed. Again, it will become 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. Like that, you have to add. This is a colligative property. When you are adding a salt or any substance, any solid substance, if you are adding to a liquid, the liquid freezing point will be decreased. Liquid freezing point will be, see here, water is a liquid. If you are adding a salt, definitely it go to minus 0.1. It go to minus 0.2. Like that, you have to keep on adding the salt. So that at 0.9 percentage of the concentration, exactly it matches the minus 0.52 degree centigrade. That is a secret. That is a concept. Okay, that is a, that you have to keep in your mind. Any drug solution to be isotonic with the blood, body fluids, it should have a freezing point minus 0.52 degrees centigrade. Its freezing point should be equal to the freezing point of the blood. Fix. So delta TF is a freezing point depression. How much it is depressed after addition of the salt? What is the freezing point before? After addition, or how much it is decreased. Okay. It is a colligative property. It comes in the subject of physical pharmacy. Very, very important. Here, what you are adding NaCl or dextrose is not important. How many particles? The colligative properties means the properties which does not depends upon the chemical nature. It is property which depends purely depends upon the number of the molecules which you have added. That we know very well. That's why it comes in the physical pharmacy, physics, entire physics. So freezing point will be depressed. Depressed, wonder. You have to wonder why water is like that. Yeah. Here we will see the problem. How much NaCl is required to render the 100 ml, see 100 ml of the 1% solution of procaine HCl. This is a target. Procaine HCl is the given solution. They have given 100 ml. 1%. 1% means we know very well. Here you can see that always concentration means grams per 100 ml. Some students, they are writing mg per 10 ml, mg per 1 ml. No, always that must be grams. Always this must be 100 only. Don't write 500, 200, 600 grams per 100 ml. 1% means 1 gram per 100 ml. 1.5% means 1.5 grams per 100 ml. Don't confusion that 100 ml, grams per 100 ml is the standard. So here 1% solution is there, 100 ml is there. So 1 gram will be there in the 100 ml. So procaine HCl to make it isotonic with the blood. See here, they have given the data. Delta TF of 1% solution of procaine HCl is 0.12 degree centigrade. So your procaine HCl solution is already having a 0.12 degree centigrade freezing point. Now you have to reduce it. This is minus only. Okay, don't get confusion. 1% procaine HCl freezing point is minus 0.12 degree centigrade. Okay, that is a given solution. Blood freezing point is equal to, we know very well, this they will not give in the examination, in the calculation, that is minus 0.52 degree centigrade. What is the difference? Here plus or minus, not the thing. What is the difference you have to see? First you have to write this and later you can be minus it so that you will get a difference. 0.40. Okay, this 0.52 is nothing but it is equal to the 0.9% of NaCl freezing point. Normal saline, it is a standard. Now you can see, you want additional depression required is a 0.40. This is additionally you have to reduce. You have to reduce so that you have to add the salt. How much we have to add? Calculation. See, 0.9% of the NaCl reduces the 0.52 degrees of the freezing point. Now, how much amount of NaCl is required for additional depression? 0.40. Okay, how much it required? Just cross multiplication. X is equal to 0.9 into 0.4 divided by 0.52. So you will get 0.69%. So if you add this much concentration of the NaCl, definitely your procaine HCl will be isotonic with the, need not to be again add, see, adding, checking, adding, freezing point. No, nothing. Calculation, direct calculation. Like, so before adjustment, isotonicity adjustment, this is a formula. Procaine HCl 1% means 1 gram of procaine HCl, 100 ml quantity sufficient to make a 100 ml. That is a before adjustment. After adjustment, procaine HCl 1 gram, NaCl, see 0.69 percentage. So 0.69 grams, grams per 100 ml, grams per 100 ml. This is 1% they have given. That's why we are taking one, okay. NaCl, see this formula. This is not isotonic. This is isotonic with the blood. Okay, like that you have to write neatly in the examination, in regular examination, before adjustment, after adjustment, the final answer, 0.69 grams is required for this calculation. We will see one more calculation. Here they ask not grams, mg. See the logic here, twist. Students don't get confusion here. First we calculate in the grams, later we can convert into mg, no problem. How many mg is required to reduce the 100 ml? Here also 100 ml. 1% solution of antipyrine solution. Okay. Delta TF. See, whenever they will give delta TF, it is a cryoscopic method. Whenever they ask how much NaCl required, class 1 method. Delta TF of 1% of antipyrine is equal to 0.10. So, blood freezing point, this one. Antipyrine, this one. How much additional depression required? 0.42. In previous calculation, it is 0.40. Here in this problem, 0.42 additional depression you require. So 0.9 NaCl equal to 0.52 degree centigrade freezing point. X 0.420. How much here is required for additional depression of 0.42? Cross multiplication. You will get 0.726. See here. So before adjustment, antipyrine 1 gram, water quantity sufficient for 100 ml. After adjustment, antipyrine 1 gram, NaCl 0.726 grams, H2O. So like that, this you have to write. Many students, they are skipping this step. You have to write it very neatly in the examination, regular exams. Okay, in competitive exam, directly you have to put. And this is also grams. That's why you have to write here grams. Here they asked mg. So whenever you are choosing the option, there may be a problem. Okay, they will give 0.726 like that they will give. They asked mg. But here it was there in the gram. You have to convert it. 1 gram is equal to 1000 mg. How many grams is equal to 0.726 grams? 0.7. Again, it's just simple cross multiplications are enough. Need not to be want to the scientific calculator. Ordinary calculator is enough. So X is equal to, like this, if you calculate, you will get a 726 mg. This is the final answer. Like that, you have to calculate. Okay. Next, we will see one more. This is the last problem. How many grams of NaCl should be added to prepare 2%? See here, there it is given 1%. Here 2% of 200 ml of morphine solution. See here, morphine solution. They give 200 ml, 2% of the morphine solution they want. But what they given the data, delta TF of 1% they given. Morphine sulfate, delta TF of morphine sulfate. See, when you concentrate in changed, freezing point depression varies. I have already told you. If you add a more and more solute, freezing point will be decreased. Now, what you have to do, percentage of desired morphine solution is 2%. Delta TF of 1% morphine is 0.08, what they have given here. Calculate for delta TF of 2% of morphine. Double it. For 1%, 0.08. For 2%, how much? We calculate it. Don't go do blindly. First, read the question carefully. What is the ml they asked? Either they asked mg, grams. What is the percentage they given? Sometimes what they will do, here they will give directly 2. Delta TF of 2% of morphine, directly they will give. So you have to read it. You have to read it. Watch it carefully. Each data, carefully you have to do. And additional depression required, how much? We will calculate now. 0.52 is a... this is blood. So delta TF of 2% morphine is equal to 0.16 degree centigrade. So additional depression required is minus 0.36. Okay. So here you can see delta 0.9 is 0.52, same. And X, how much amount is required for 0.36 additional depression? So you will get a X as a 0.623. That is a, this is a percentage. This is not end. The problem is not end here. See, before adjustment, what is the formula? Morphine solution, 2%, 100 ml, 2 grams per 100 ml, because 2% they want. After adjustment, morphine solution, 2 gram, NaCl is, see here what we got is percentage, 0.62. Percentage means grams per 100 ml. Okay. So NaCl is equal to 0.62 grams. Quantity sufficient? 100 ml. QS to produce. Now, but not answer, answer not end here. In the question, they asked for 200 ml. But above formula is 100 ml only. Okay. Now, what you have to do for 100 ml, 0.62. Okay. For double, 200 ml, how much? You have to double it. Okay. So, your answer is double of this. 1.246 grams of NaCl is required to prepare the 2% of 200 ml of the morphine sulfate solution. Final formula, morphine sulfate 4 grams. Because 200 ml, no, you require 4 grams. NaCl, 1.246. And quantity sufficient, 200 ml you produce. That is the final formula. So in the exam, don't get confusion. That's why here clear cutly I have mentioned. In my channel playlist, I have kept all videos. Just keep on watching.